Hello, welcome to On the Media. I'm your host, Avery Crable, and joined with me are
Rachel,
Gage,
Dyer.
Today we are going to be talking about our interview that we did about media in our society. Let's jump right into it. First, let's go around and say who we interviewed, their age in relation to us, and then I'll ask some questions. So I interviewed my mom, and she's 41.
I interviewed my dad, and he is 59.
I interviewed my mom, and she is 50.
I interviewed my grandma, she's 86, and she's from Kenya.
So for the first question, what did your interviewees have to say about their use of media as a kid? My mom said she had a TV in the family room. It was on all the time, but they really only paid attention during the news. And then they had the daily newspaper, but then they would wait for the news for more information.
My dad said that they had multiple TVs in their house. They were all black and white at first, and then color. And then they also received a daily newspaper, which they got a lot of their news from as well.
And my mom, she had one TV in the house, but then for other entertainment and news, she would also get magazines and the daily newspaper as well.
My grandma never really had any personal media. There was one radio in the house that was controlled by her father, so my great-grandpa. So she never really had any social media or any media back in the day. It's just personal relations with her friends, and that's how she kind of lived.
For the second question, it says, how did they stay in touch with their friends? So funny story, my mom would actually pass a notebook around in class as if she was taking notes, but really they were trying to communicate on what they would do later that night. Or it would be by home phone, and they would have to talk to the parents, which you don't normally do anymore. Like, I just pick up my phone and ask if they want to go hang out.
My dad was kind of the same. He would talk to his friends at school. Through verbal communication, they would all make plans for the day, pick a time and a place, and then they would just hope that everyone would be there. If something was more last minute, they would use their home phone. So again, like Avery said, they would have to talk to parents, which nowadays you don't really have to. I don't really have to talk to my friend's parents unless it's an emergency. So
yeah, my mom, she would ride bikes around town, kind of just see, knock on everybody's door, kind of have that face-on-face interactions. And if she wasn't doing that, then she would grab the home phone and just call their home.
With my grandma, it was kind of what Rachel mentioned, just word of mouth in school as well. And she would walk miles, many miles, just to, in hopes of seeing her friends, not even knowing they're there or not, because they couldn't communicate. That's the only way of communicating. And then during the summer, they'd write letters to each other, which is uncertain. Nowadays, we can just send a message and we know they receive it. So, yeah.
I feel like after walking miles and miles, I would get so annoyed if they weren't there.
Yeah, it's just unfortunate.
What did your interviewee have to say about the impact of technology on our society? My mom says the communication has gotten a lot worse, that we don't hold eye contact as well, and that you don't really see kids outside playing anymore.
My dad was kind of similar. He said there's a really big lack of verbal communication, because now it's a lot easier. You can just hide behind a cell phone and you don't really have to talk face to face. A lot of people would rather text or email than physically pick up the phone and call someone. I know for me, I would prefer texting if I'm talking to someone that I don't know very well. So I just think that's a really big difference in today's society.
Yeah, and with my mom being a teacher, she can kind of see firsthand on how it's kind of impacting the younger generation. And one of the main points she said to me was that younger people kind of struggle to hold eye contact for a longer amount of time and kind of just struggle with keeping conversations going with some people they aren't familiar with.
My grandma sympathizes with our generation because she feels if we're missing out on a lot of real life relations that she had back in the day. You know, seeing people in person, not just through the phone. She always complains when me and my siblings are on the devices so much. So she knows it's good. It's how we're heading forward as a society. But as long as we use it in moderation and we don't abuse it, I think, yeah, that's her outlook on it.
So how did the media that your interviewees grew up on with have an impact on their views on world events? My mom, as I said before, got the daily newspaper, so that's how she first heard of it. And then she would hear from the news later that night for more information, or it would just be her parents.
Yeah, my dad was kind of similar. They got the daily newspaper, which is kind of one-sided. If you only got one newspaper, you really only had one point of view on situations. And then he would also watch the news every day with his family. And the news channels that were on were always chosen by my grandpa because he got the final say. So I think he got a lot of his views from his dad. So that had a really big role in how he interacted with certain media events.
And with my mom only having one TV in the house, she wasn't in control of kind of what was on, so she kind of just got all her views by what her parents were talking about or just like what they were watching on the TV.
Firstly, my grandma was going through a civil war at that time, so there was a lot of conflict within the country called the Mau Mau in Kenya. They had a weekly newspaper, they had one radio, and then just a lot of rumors in school, so they would just have to clarify with each other's parents. So I could just imagine living that time as a teenager is very scary, very uncertain. You don't know what's going on, what's next. So
yeah, and I feel like I would be always itching for new information, but you wouldn't know for like that next week.
Yeah.
So our last question, did their view on technology change during or after the pandemic? My mom said it changed afterwards because she decided she wanted to be more grateful for technology just because we were able to talk to my family from Seattle and get to keep up with all of them out there, even though we only see them like twice a year.
My dad was somewhere. He was very grateful for technology during the pandemic because he works in international business supply chain. So he interacts with people from other countries almost every single day. And before the pandemic, before like Zoom and all those different types of technology, he would have to physically travel to those countries to have meetings that would take like an hour, and then that would be a 3 days worth of travel. It would cost time and money, where as of now with Zoom and Microsoft Teams, they can be more efficient at work. So it definitely helped his view on technology be more positive.
Yeah, and with my mom's work, she had to transfer everything from in-person to computer and over Zoom, so she had to get more familiar with technology. And for her, that's definitely a good thing, because with how society is going with technology, it's kind of transferring over there. So with her being more familiar with it, definitely helped her out a lot.
My grandma appreciated it way more after COVID, because she's very religious. So she used to attend daily Christian meetings, which was not possible, of course, due to COVID. So she had to learn a lot of uses of apps like Zoom and everything just to communicate with the church and her congregation and a lot of her friends. So she appreciated it more, and she just, you know, even now she always tells me, you can use your devices, just use it in moderation and don't abuse it, and set an amount of time a day, don't, you know. So she's not totally against it, but she knows how, where it's going, and she just appreciated it.
I don't know if I could ever be a teacher going from in-person to Zoom and having to switch all my stuff. Well, that's all the time we have for today. It was a lot of fun to do these interviews, and I hope you had fun too. Until next time.